Hello, today I'm going to show you how the 2017 CLA's command online system works. What you have is navigation, radio, media, telephone, vehicle, panning, destination, position, traffic, and options. The command online is controlled via this knob. Back, and for favorite settings, you can turn the knob. There is additional features here: radio, media, navigation, telephone, mute, and to go into the CAS digital online manual. So if we go to the navigation, we will see a different layout. You will have navigation, Qibla, compass, information on navigation, etc. Let's demonstrate how the GPS functions in the Mercedes CLA with command online. Destination, continue route guidance, address entry, keyword search, from last destinations, from contacts, points of interest, using map, etc. One can also add from Mercedes-Benz apps and geo-coordinates. Let's do a address entry. Let's go to, not a country, but a town, Cape Town, for instance. It will highlight the possible last letters of the alphabet, Cape Agulhas. We make sure that we scroll and select down to Cape Agulhas, select enter, and then we can add the street, the town, the country or the map, but we say start. And just as an idea, let's zoom out a little bit to give an orientation. And there we are. Covering the navigation part of command online, let's move on to the radio. This is the following radio stations.
This is a massive shift, right? So the fourth industrial.
So it's rather quite clean. No noise. The vehicle is fitted with Bluetooth. You can go to your telephone options and you can add or dial numbers by either connecting a device, calling lists or using options, or you can use the keypad to dial the numbers, or you can use the knob to select these numbers, but once only if the phone is connected to the vehicle. At this stage it won't do anything. Let's go to the vehicle settings. The vehicle settings, the different options, dynamic select for individual configuration. If many wanted to know what that I actually means, the owner's manual digitally with more information than the booklet, but once again accessible from that feature from the command online, time, vehicle settings, etc. If we go into the dynamic select, we get the individual configuration and the engine data. The engine data compromises a readout of a system of Newton meters in torque and kilowatts as the vehicle progresses. Currently, the vehicle's temperature engine is at 19 degrees because it's been driven about maybe a day or so ago, and zero for the oil. But over a period of 24 hours, these figures would be a bit higher, maybe 40 degrees, depending on how hard you have driven the vehicle. We go back. In individual configuration, Currently the vehicle needs to be on to detect the settings. So let's switch it quickly on. There's some fuel consumption ideas of miles. 12.3 kilometers per 100. Then it goes on. I'm just gonna put off the aircon. Now you can see that it has its different settings to the drive to set. The sport mode, the electronic stability program, etc. Going back, we go to vehicle settings. We can have the vehicle's locator illumination settings on or off. For example, when the vehicle's lights is on while locked, or the mirror side lights is off or on. We can have the interior lighting delayed shut off. We can have the exterior lighting delayed shut off with a timer. We can have the ambient lighting features of the vehicle, which I will demonstrate in a while. And we can have the locator illumination. That the vehicle also needs to be on for those settings to be set. If we go into the time menu, we get automatic time settings. In this instance, South Africa. Set the time manually and the format. We get the owner's manual by pressing or by selecting the icon. There it just says, please make sure to read the following notes in the owner's manual. If you do not, you could fail to recognize these dangers, etc. We click next. And now we are in the owner's manual with highlights, bookmarks, help, language settings, content, visual search, keyword search, highlights, etc. Let's go to the help, or let's just maybe do a keyword search, for instance. Let's read about Formatic. For those doesn't know what Formatic is. Okay, so it says Formatic currently unavailable. The Formatic has overheated. The vehicle is only driven by the front wheels. Drive on. The airflow cools Formatic more quickly when the display message goes out. Formatic is available again, and the vehicle is driven by all four wheels. That is only an error. So let's say you have a problem with your Formatic, then the digital manual will probably give you that last feature. Most of these are rather problems that can be looked up and not generally definitions. Let's just see what type of languages there are. Currently this vehicle supports, I don't know about the other models, but it supports English, Espanol, France, and Portuguese, it seems. Possibly one can maybe download extra languages, I'm not sure. Maybe you can give your comments in the section below. And that's the owner's manual of the vehicle. Let's just make sure if there's another more features here. Vehicle settings. You've been to that. Dynamic select is the individual configuration. Time and then goodies. In the next menu, we have system settings. System settings comprises of the following features: your favorite functions, language, display, Linguatronic, speaking to the GPS, text reader speed, rear view camera, Wi-Fi, and activate Bluetooth by default. One can also import export data and reset these features. Another time menu, and the display can also be shut off. I think that is command online. In a sense, it has actually a lot more features than meets the eye. It has DVD and Dolby Digital surround sound. I did take the delivery of installing the Harman Kardon sound system. If you guys want to hear it, leave your comments below and I'll upload another video. And I will also upload another video to show you how the vehicle's dimming works in the evening. And yes, that's that. Thank you for watching. And please subscribe.